Eminem is probably the most notorious pop star in the world right now. He's controversial and proud of it.
I don't try to, you know, polish up my shit for nobody. I don't, you know, I tell it like it is. And when you buy a Slim Shady album, you're gonna get Slim Shady. You're not gonna get birds and bees and flowers and trees.
But compared to most rap stars, Eminem's crimes have been pretty tame. Was dressing up as Osama bin Laden in a video a poor publicity stunt or just plain offensive? Well, it made us laugh. But if you're gonna hang around with Snoop Doggy Dogg and Dr. Dre, you've gotta be harder than that. Eminem needed to earn his stripes. So last June, he went back to his hometown, Detroit, and confronted John Guerra, a man who made the mistake of kissing Eminem's wife, Kim. Not what you do to a tough guy rapper.
I was kissing his wife, you know, and I won't apologize for that, ever. You know, why should I? I'm not the one that had pursued her that night, you know? She came to me. If you can't control your wife and keep her happy at home, then don't come to me crying because she did.
John and Eminem both grew up in a working-class district of Detroit. The fight took place here at 2 a.m. outside this nightclub where John used to be a bouncer. He'd been kissing Kim in the parking lot when suddenly he was confronted by a stranger in a baseball cap.
The guy came around from the front of the van, came over Kim's shoulder with a gun, you know, not even in front of me, and put it right in my face, you know, and I mean, just point blank, and that's when I grabbed it. And they were sitting there, and he's trying to pull it, and he's telling me, I'm gonna kill you, I'm gonna kill you. And I'm like, I don't even know you, what the hell are you doing? That's when I spun him around and slammed him on the hood of the car. And that's when I let go of the gun. And that was my big mistake. That's when he started hitting me with the gun. I mean, he just started pounding me from, he hit me here first, and he kept hitting me back here because I brought my head down to his chest, and then I came up on my head. And I'm slamming the arm out, and that's when he let go of the gun. And by the time he let go of the gun, I let up on his face. And when I let up on his face, that's when I seen who it was. And before you know it, bam, boom, bam. I'm just actually stumbling backwards. I couldn't believe it. Now I'm in awe because I just seen his face. That is when I realized who it was. That's when I was like, holy shit, that's Eminem. This guy just pulled a gun out on me.
That's scary. I don't care who you are, how big you are, how tough you are. When you get a gun, which is called an equalizer for a reason, you know, it makes a little man and a big man pretty around the same size.
John pressed charges for being assaulted with a deadly weapon. Eminem faced 5 years in prison. At the trial, he looked more like Harry Potter than the real Slim Shady.
The irony was that before the judgment, he looked absolutely petrified. And so therefore, when it comes to the crunch, there's a complete fear.
He would have gotten 5 years at least. You know, I know I would have if it had been me.
But as the biggest rap star in the world, Eminem can afford the best lawyers. He convinced the court the gun wasn't loaded and pleaded guilty to a lesser charge. He got 2 years probation.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.